So thank you, Julia, for giving this lecture. Visual design is important she will introduce general principle of visual design, and you will see the application for designing web interfaces. So it's an important part for your project, and will also help you to understand some layout usability principle that I introduce in my usability lesson. Two things. BIP is really overstressed. Therefore, in many moments, it does not work. So you should have received the slides, Julia's slides, by email through Servizio Online. And I posted the link to the drop-off file on the chat. If you don't receive it or you cannot download it, send me an email and I will send it directly by email. Second, there is a question in the chat about explaining what the difference between structural navigation and semantic navigation. You will better understand these concepts after today's lesson, my lesson tomorrow. But the idea is the following. Structural navigation is the navigation among contents of the same topic, of the same conceptual object. So when I navigate from the presentation of a course to the suggested learning material, to the schedule of the course, to the course reviews by students, I'm navigating across the different pieces of the same topic, a given course. Instead, when I move from a topic to another different topic, such as from a course to the teacher of the course, I'm changing the topic because conceptually the course is something different from the teacher, even though they have a relationship. So when navigation is exploiting the relationship, the semantic relationship between items, between topics, that is semantic navigation. When you have the feeling of moving inside among parts, among different perspectives, among different components of something that you can define as the same object, that is structured navigation. Of course, it's an arbitrary distinction, because one can say that the course is part of a teacher or the teacher is part of a course. So it's an opportunistic decision to be made to define them as separate topics. It's a matter of common sense. But in general, it's important to distinguish this relationship between something that could be conceived as different versus something that it could be conceived as pieces of the same object. That said, I will follow the lesson remotely because I'm locating in my department. Julia is located in the lab. She will stop at some points to look at your chats. Thank you for being here. Thank you for being interactive. And we are here for any question. So thank you, Julia. And please go ahead.
Okay. Can you hear me, first of all? Okay, perfect. Okay, as the professor said, today we are going to see some basic elements of visual design and principles. And first of all, I want to know if you have ever heard about visual design as a term. So you can just put thumb up or down as visual design in the chat, just to see if you have a still no voice. Okay. Can you hear me now? Okay. Perfect. So most of you put the thumb up. So can you give me some words or definition about visual design? It's okay, just words or something that appear in your mind when you think about these terms. Can you hear me? Okay. So, visual design focuses on the aesthetics of a site and distributed materials by strategically implementing images, color, fonts, and other elements. Okay, this is a very good definition. Layout, graphics, typography. Okay, okay, I think that here we are. Usually common people thought that visual design is just a sketch or colorful wireframe. So just something that is related to pretty pictures or images. But today I'm going to show you why visual design is important for build a very good interface or a website. So first of all, it's about creating a beautiful experience for your user. And it is good to create a well-designed system. And systems could be a product, service, or a website. And it is a compromise between the functionalities of your interface and the emotion that you want to convey to your user through your interface. Through visual design, you can also tell a sort of storytelling in your interface during the experience that the user do in your website. So basically, the visual design goals is to improve the user experience, considering the effects of illustration, images, layout, grids, color, on the usability of your product, service, or interface, and on their aesthetic appeal. So it helps the designer to achieve this goal through visual design, through elements, basic elements and the principles. In particular, the main aim, the real aim is to engage people in your service. So in this process, the small details of your product is really important. Because it changes the experience of your user and also create their trust and interest in your product. So often in modern term, you can find the UI as another definition of visual design. Usually, a lot of people confuse the UX and the UI because, you know, it is part of the same process, but the UI is just one part, a little part of the entire process of the UX. As you can see in these images, it's just a little part, and one analogy could be that the UX design is the vehicle and the UI design is just driving console of your vehicle. Just to be more precise, we can start from a quotation of Don Norman, that is the inventor of the term user experience, that give a different importance to the design of a product. So in a world in which the complexity is more and more important, he said that a product is not just a product, but a mix of an integrated and cohesive set of experience. And you design a product when you design a product, you have to think about all the necessary stage of it. So we as designer, we think as user experience as different steps. We don't have time to do all these steps, but I hope to let you understand something of it. So the goals of our steps is to center all the user experience on the end user. And we start from the why, what, and how. So when we think about why, we have to think about why we want to develop this idea. So our motivation, our values, our view. And then, so only when we finish this part of research, we start to think about the functionalities. So what is our product and what are the functionalities and the future of our product? And finally, we think about how to do it in terms of accessibility and aesthetics. So what the user see finally. To do this, we follow steps, as I said. This is the process that usually we follow during our research. So the emphatization, the definition, the ideation, the prototypation, the test of our product, service, or interface. Because this is the design thinking process, and is a non-linear and iterative process, so you can go back every time you think that is necessary during this process to redefine the problem and create an innovative solution, then prototype and test it, and if it is possible to redo it again in order to create a really good and well-designed solution for your user. So this method allow you to think outside the box, and I think that this is the key of the success of the most global organization as Apple, Google, etc. And just to let you understand more in detail all the steps, we can start from the emphatize. So this is the step, in which you understand your user. Usually, as a designer, we did it with observations, but also interview. In this phase, we use a lot of empathy. So we try to understand what is the real needs of our user in order to solve them it in a very good way during the whole process. So the next step is the definition of our idea. In this phase, we try to accumulate all the information that we create and gather during the empathize phase. And we analyze them in order to define the core of the problem and identified it so far. So in this phase, we are going to create the, for example, the main scenario in which the user will navigate during the experience that we discover in the previous phase. So the next step is the ideation. In this phase, with your solid background of knowledge that you have from the two first phases, you can create a very good ideas. And in this phase, it's the phase of brainstorming, so you can think really outside the box. You can look for really alternative ways to convey your solution and solve the problems of the users. You will be ready to create and then develop a really good product. Sorry. After this phase, there is the prototypation phase. So this is an really experimental phase. You can apply different solution, and the aim is to identify what is the best solution to implement in terms also in terms of feasibility also. So is just to start to create solution in the best way. The last phase is to test your solution. And this is a really important phase because with the evaluation of your interface or product, you can understand for real the output of the user. You can understand their feedback, and also what are their feelings using your product or interface. So in all this, the entire process, the user experience and the interaction design is more in the ideation part. Then between them, we can think about the visual design. So when you start to prototype your interface, you already understood the user needs, you define your solution, you think about all the ways to create it, and then you start to think about the rules, the design rules of your interface in order to shape a really good prototype to test with your user. So in order to create a really good aesthetic styles for your website, it is important to start from basic elements of visual design. And this is crucial because also a basic element can help you to convey what you want from your user. Okay, so the first one is the line. So this is an elementary concept from elementary schools, so the stroke connected to points. And this is the most basic element of a visual design. We can use it to create different shapes. We can repeat them in order to form different patterns and texture. And it has a large variety of properties that allow you to convey a different range of expressions. So, for example, lines can be thick or thin, straight or curved, and can also be implied. So it can suggest something that is not visible, but could be just a connection between different elements in your space, in your interface or website. The second one is a shape. So the shape is a self-contained areas, usually formed by lines, and it has two dimensions, the length and width. The shape can be composed as a line, as I said, but also with different colors or texture or value. And we use it in order to convey effective communication to let the user understand better how we organize the space And every shape creates a negative space that is an empty space and a positive space that is a space that is full of color or texture or images, for example. This is an example. So as you said, as I said, the negative space is the empty one and help the user to rest, and the positive shape capture the attention of your user. This is another example of the WWF logo, and you concentrate your attention in the positive space. And your eyes understood all the shape of the panda of the logo. The third value, the third element is the value. So it describes light and dark. And this is really important for the contrast in your website, and it creates clarity. So the user can understand better your section and what is important during the navigation in your interface. So the volume, we rarely use the volume in visual design because most of digital product end up to be 2D dimension, but it could be useful when you have to convey, for example, 3D models and graphics. So it depends about the topic of your website, and could be useful sometimes. Another important element, this is a really important element, this is the color. And the color theory allow you to convey the motion of your website or interface, and it had a variety of interest in your design, and helps you to separate different page, different areas, and allow you to differentiate your product with another product, for example. Now I'm going to show you the basics, the color, the color wheel. And when you build your interface, you have to ask yourself, what does this color mean for my project, and why I need this color, and what is the emotion that I express with this color. Also, pay attention to the contrast and to the interplay between the primary color, so yellow, blue, red, and secondary color, green, violet, orange, and the tertiary color. As you can see, the colors can have different meaning, and the warmest color usually convey passion, impulsive, and happiness, but also comfort and coziness. And on the other side, the cool colors can convey trust or professionalism, but also confidence and stability. So take in mind what you want to convey with your interface when you choose a precisely color. So the other, another important element is the texture. The texture is about the quality of some element in your interface, and It can be created by repeated patterns of lines, of course, but also with colors. And most of visual designers will work with implied textures, since the screen is not a tactile texture, of course. So it's just an abstraction of a texture. This is some examples. As you remember, this is the icon of Apple with glossy textures of glass. And then another kind of texture with flat design. So this is a different way to convey something different from your user. So the typography is the last element and refer to the font that you choose. And this is really important to convey hierarchy of your interface and also be attention to choose a font that is legible from your user, readable, and I will show you some tools in order to choose a right font for your website. So now, before continues with the design principles, I just want to give you a sort of quick quiz about the visual elements design. So, just a moment. Okay. So I will give you just 5 to 10 minutes in order to answer these quick text. And this is just to have some more interactive lecture. So you can find what I said from now and just have fun with this kind of quick text. So let me know when you finish and if you have some question of something about this section. You can just put the thumb up when you finish in the chat. And I will see you with your answer when you finish. Okay. Okay, you can see the correct answers when you finish. Okay. The answer is arriving. So most of you do seven out of 10 or 8 out of 10. Okay, AA 1 out of 10 if you have some question, I'm here. You don't write your name, of course. Of course. Okay, was tricky. What is the one about the colors? Okay, also Najib, if you have some question, ask me. Okay, about the color question, I mean, it was a really basic test, so I mean, if one question was tricky, it's just to bring more funny about it. Okay. So most of you understood whole. So you said, I thought that first we evoke some emotion and then we connect. Yes, it's not about to order it, but just to let you understand how the color is used in the design of your interface. So of course, if I see a colors that capture my attention, then I connect my view to the interface. So the this is a way to use a color, of course. Positive space gives user eyes to change the rest. Yes, the first question is because the positive space is the one that capture the user attention, and the negative one is the one that helps the user to rest during the navigation in your interface, as I show in these slides. One moment. This one. So the positive shape allow the user to capture in something that you want to convey to your user. Yes, the answer is was all the above about the how is color used in design. Okay, no. About the quality, as I said before, a texture can convey is not is but is about more the as I said before. One moment. I have to search for the slides. Okay, as you can see here, the space, I mean, is all the space, and the texture gives the opportunity to understand for real what the brands want to convey. So is the quality of the surface of I mean, you can use color lines or whatever, but is about I don't know how to say in the correct terms, but is like, yes, the surface of a button, an icon, or also a background. I mean, this is just a texture for a background, so it conveys something about your quality as a brand, as the producer of your interface. Okay, it's my mistake. The correct answer is all the above, of course. I will change quickly. Okay, perfect. Okay, sorry. Okay. Okay, we can go ahead. Perfect. Okay, just one moment. Okay, so we speak about the elements of visual design, so line shapes, negative space, volume, color, and texture, and it describes the building blocks of product aesthetics. But the principles of visual design tell us how the element can and should go together in order to obtain the best results in your interface. So the first one is the unity. The unity creates a sense of harmony between your elements, and a lack of unity in design your interface can create a sense of chaos. And when you are designing a website, you can use, for example, a grid to help you to organize your element and arrange it in a very good way. While this is the Gestalt principle. Sorry. What you say, I still see the previous slides of negative and positive space. Okay. One moment, I change. Okay, now. Can you see the slide of Gestalt? Okay, perfect. Okay, so this is the unity slide, the first one, that represents, as I said, the sense of organization in your web page or interface. Then the Gestalt principle refers to our brain tendency to perceive the sum of all parts as opposed to the individual elements, and it is really important to convey the clear distinction between different sections in your website. And as a designer, we should make sure that the part of a website we group together by using Gestalt principle are grouped together. Accidentally grouping elements that are not conceptually similar is really confusing for the user. So this is an example of the Gestalt elements. The Gestalt principles, the WWF logo, because by placing the parts of Panda near together strategically, allows you to create an illusion of a panda, but it's not like that. It's just part of something put one another in a very good way. The third principle is a hierarchy, and it shows the different importance between the elements in a design. So you can convey hierarchy also through colors, for instance, by highlighting primary button, or using, for example, larger font for headings. And when you design these kind of things, you have to think about what should the user look first. So what is the most important things that I want to show to the user? And then the other element in a hierarchy, a precisely hierarchy in your interface. Another important principle is the balance. So is how you distribute the elements in the space, and the balanced design, a balanced interface tend to appear calm, stable, and natural. Then an imbalanced interface makes the user feel uncomfortable with your interface. And however, you can achieve balance also without symmetry. But pay attention, you have to be really clear that you do it for purpose. And a beautiful composition of the elements is immediately recognizable, and because it is harmonious and balanced, so the human brain perceive it in a really fast way. The contrast, so we use the contrast in order to highlight something, and we can use it with color, value, or also size. This is an example of a high contrast of the delayed action, that is often something that is irreversible. And usually we use this concept with a red button, and in another on the other hand, the green one is often used in a positive action. So for example, to accept something, to go ahead in something, some other pages. And when you design your interface, take in account also the culture of your users, because the colors meaning change from different culture in the world. So the scale describes the relative size of the element. And you can also use scale to create a sense of depth, because a nearer object appears larger, is larger to the human eye. So scale can be used also to create hierarchy and for add some emphasis to a certain elements on a design of a web interface. Okay, the dominance allow you to focus on something in your interface, and you can use shapes, contrast, color, and this is an example of when you enter in a website and you see the hero image of the website. This is an example of dominance, and you can use it by positioning element in a precise space, or use color, as I said. This is an example, a really clear example, Google. So as you can see, the dominance is the large Google logo and the search box, that making the core of the web page. They use contrast, so the Google's logo use bright colors, and this is mixed very well. Because there is a sufficient contrast against the background and the colors used for the logo. The principles of the elements of the shapes, that is the search box, represented with rectangular shapes, and it delineates something that you can tap and use, and this is very simple and usable from the user. The negative space, it is the predominant in a Google web homepage, and this is use like this to concentrate your attention in the dominance space. In all of the other background is just to allow the user to center their attention in a precise focus. And the balance.
Julia?
Yes.
Julia, sorry for interrupting you. There is a question, which is what is the difference between scale and dominance? Are they related?
Okay. Yes, they are related in a sense that you can use it for the same purpose, but they are quite different because the scale is about to relate different elements using scale, and it can achieve a sense of depth between the elements. So you can perceive something that is very far and something that is very near. But the dominance is more about focus, the attention of the user or something that it is, so a single element that is in dominance the rest of the page. I was clear. It is, as I said, you can use it for the same purpose, but with, in a different way. Okay. Okay, thank you. The last principle that you can see in this page is the balance. So the page is almost vertically symmetrical, and this is the result of a sense of balance that is very pleasing and calm to look at. So I want to show you another example, just another one about Quartz. This is just an agency. This is really different from Google, but you can see the same principles and elements. So you can see a hierarchy between the typography, because you have the headings that is in bold, and you can see that is more important than the other stories above. And as you can see, there is the other stories put in a grid that gives a sense of unity to the page. And another element is the queue in the background that gives so it's a sort of hero images for the main story, and it quickly establishes the identity of your website that is represented by Quartz, so Q. There is a lot of negative space that allow you to concentrate to the part of the title and the other stories. So now it's your turn. So I want to ask you what is the best design of these two websites, and if you can also tell me why, and if you can notice some principles and elements in why someone is balanced or unbalanced, in why there is dominance in one and why there is no dominance in another one, for example. if there is some volunteers that want to participate in. Okay, the one has no unity. Okay, two, because there is more hierarchy between the elements, your attention focus on the upper part because it has different color, good. No dominance, no color, are mess. Okay, in the first one. It's not good since there is too much content. The sections are not really linking, and there is no negative element on which to rest. Of course, very good point. Two, because there is a balance between elements and the scale are the same for the same concept element. Yes. Okay. Okay, perfect. In the first view, we can see that the second one is better because of some points you mentioned earlier, but actually the first one has better experience, although it has a good visual design. Okay, why the first one has a better experience for you? Okay, it's not always good that as a user you can have all the data in one page if you can't find the data because it's not organized in a very well way. So it's better to have different pages that allow you to do different steps, but maybe it's more quickly in the second case to find something than in the first one. It is clear? You know, user always click on a page and stay maximum for 3 seconds. Okay, I think that this is the fact, I mean, this is what I said. Probably it is more difficult to find something in 3 seconds in the first page. Probably you need 5 minutes to find something. Yeah, of course. So we can go ahead to other examples. So the same, so there are different concepts, but you can find the same element in principle probably. Can you give me some other? Differences? Better contrast so we can see everything better, of course. Something else? Something regarding some elements? Too little contrast, okay. More hierarchy, but also the, another element. Okay, the typo, of course, but also, actually, I don't like both, okay. In the first one, I don't know It is the focus content. The second one, the color palette for important, and it's not really pleasing. Okay. Okay, I think that the focus of this page is the fact that you get in touch with Mark, and so they use this shape with this texture that allow you to understand that you click it and get in touch with him. About the contrast, I think that he uses a really good contrast between the green and the red. I understood what you said about it is fight, the colors fight, but is the case in which the color fight in a good way, because they represent styles of these digital designer and front-end developer, for example. I can almost see the focus on the second element that distracts me on the content. Okay, could be that. Okay, perfect. So the last example. Okay, and how they convey the right information? Yeah, in the first one you focus just on the guides, right? And the second one, the text is not really readable, but it's more organized. Yeah, I agree. Probably it's about the transparency that they use for a button. Maybe with a button without transparency and with more shadow allow you to read more the information and to tap it. Maybe the first one has an animation and then it is more interactive. Yes, it's interactive, but a bit confusing because you don't know if you can click to the images or you can just see the images, and you have the menu that it is not really clear about color and not convey the fact that you can interact with it. I was referring to the bigger text. Okay, so about be a local anywhere you go. Okay, yes, this is because probably the background, as Pietro said, is not really negative. And so maybe they can put the background more in transparency, more to a white background, and helps the user to read the information in a very good way. So we can go last one, maybe to see. Okay, this is just Paulina said that maybe to see the space is more pleasant than the back. This is a choice, I think. It depends about what they want to convey as a topic more than the images that they choose. Okay. Okay, so we can go ahead. So here I just want to show you some examples about bad design. Let me show you. Okay. Moment. Okay. So this is just a funny web page in which you can see different bad design in terms of things, displays, controls, names of labels. I just want to show you some of them. Okay, just one moment. Okay. Okay, this is an example. For example, in this case, you don't have different shape of different color or of what you of the information that you need when you want to know, for example, how much is the gas. So design suggestion could be to have different position or different color in order to help the user to read in a better way the information. Another example, one moment, that because I just write down some of them. Okay. So I think that most of you know these problems. And I mean, the USB connector has the same entrance. And so, I mean, you have the images that represent that you can put in, but maybe make it with different connectors helps you to solve this problem. Okay, I leave you this link so you can have fun and see a lot of examples of bad design and solutions that you can apply to this. Now we can continue with the presentation. Okay, so at this point we saw a lot of visual design elements and principles. Remember who is your user when you design your interface, and for interface, I mean everything could be a product, a service, or a web page. So in this image, you can see that the designer think about something for a kid, but then is something for parents, and the real user don't have a really good experience with your product. So now I want to give you some useful tools to use during the design of your interface. So first of all, try to start with an inventory that is called in the design school as the design systems. So start from the atoms of your web page, then go with molecules, organization, templates, and then page. So I want to show you just an example of Airbnb design systems. Okay. Sorry, one moment. Okay, now you can see. Okay, this is the visual language of Airbnb. As you can see, they think about the typo, so the basic elements of their interface. So about the typography, the colors, the spacing, and they also think about the components, so the molecules and then the layout of their interface, and they apply it for every type of devices. It could be a web page, could be an app, or whatever, could be also a product, but it has to respect the rules that they defined before. So they create the components, and also they think about all the navigation and the flow that the user has to follow during their experience. Okay. Now we can. Continue, just one moment. Okay. So, first of all, think about the icons of your web page. You can use material icons or noun project. You have the link in the slides. You can, in this sense, try to be coherent during this decision. So you have to choose a really cohesive and coherent icons between all the page. This is another useful tool for create a palette color. So you have the material tool and the material palette. You can select a primary color and it suggests you the secondary one and some other hints for the error. For example, you can try it and you can write me an email if you need some help with it. Important tools is the components one of material design of Google. You can see a lot of components such as button or navigation in the web interface. Okay, Google Forms. I just want to show you this one, because I think that could be very useful for you. So here you can find a lot of different fonts. And for example, if I choose Roboto, Then you can also read the description of how usually it's used, what is the different styles of Roboto, and also in which countries used most, and how many download of this font. Moreover, another important thing is that there are different popular pairings with the font, so you can understood what is the best pairings, and you can choose from them, you can try it, and you can also change it in order to understand what is the best match in this sense. So selecting this font, then you already have the link that you can put in your CSS, and you can have also the font family to put in the rules of the CSS. So it's really useful when you have to import it in your code. Okay. So in order to do a good layout and wireframes, you can use different tools as Sketch, Adobe XD, and Figma. And I will show you just to let you understand one of them. One moment. Okay, so for example, this is Adobe XD, and this is just an interface that I'm doing for the lab. So in this tool, you can use different shapes, and also you can upload different kits from Apple, Material Design, etc. I think that your colleague of design have it for free. You can ask to them if you have a designer in a group. Otherwise, you can find some imitation online and you can use it for free. This is very useful because you can design it, prototype it, so you can link a button and try to create a flow between the screens and then share it. So will appear a link and you can share with your user and try to test it in a very simple and easy way. Okay, we can go to the slides. Sorry, just one moment. Okay. Okay, the minimum usually is this one, Of course, but it depends about what you want to convey. I mean, if it is a button, probably you won't use 16 pixels. It depends about where you want to put, if it is an heading, if it is just a paragraph, it is some information. As I said before, remember the hierarchy and what you want to convey with your user. Okay. Okay, now I show you to you the slides, just for a moment. Okay, now you can see the slides. Okay, we almost finished. To the end, remember that when you design your website, when a user, when you when use your interface, perceive it in a more usable way when you design it in a very good visual way. And Professor Garzotto will show you the different guidelines of the usability of your interface. Is the visibility of the system status, the match between the system and the real world, the user control during their experience, the cost instances that your website web have during all the experience, and also the flexibility and the efficiency of your website. If I have time, just 5 minutes to show you just these case studies. Okay, this is a conversational web interface called Easy. As you can see, we use different contrast between the positive and negative space. And this is the button that the user has to press in order to activate the conversational agent, and this is the animation used to let the user understand when it is active and when he wanted to speak with it. Another beautiful work that we did is this one called Magica. That is a controller interface. This Magica is a smart environment, and we did a control interface for the therapist to control it. And we think about first, as I said, to the design system in terms of typography, icon system, palette, and everything. So the components as button, cards, and whatever. And then we design the interface for them. So remember the negative space, the positive space, the clear distinction between the contrast. So for activate something or to help the user navigate through it in a very simple way. This is some tips for filter it. So remember that when you can help the user to navigate it, do it in the best possible way. Okay, and that's it. So if you have some other you can see the slides. Perfect. One moment. Now?
Okay, thank you, Junia. If there are no additional questions, we will stop the registration. As I mentioned at the beginning, BIP is not working properly due to too many accesses to the system. So we were not able to post the slides, but you should have received them by email, and there is a link to Dropbox file at the beginning of this chat. We will see tomorrow with a lesson about usability testing. And tomorrow we'll also present some milestone for the future agenda of the course and the future deliverables. So thank you, everybody. Have a nice day. Julia, if you could turn the registration off. Thank you.
Yes.
Bye-bye.
Bye-bye.